So we will see about the further, that is rescue terpenes. Which are having 15 carbon atom compounds. So it will be giving rise to rescue terpenes. Three isoprene units are combining together to form one rescue terpene. इसका स्ट्रक्चर हमने देखा था लास्ट टाइम पे, दैट इज दिस कैन बी सेस्क्यू टर्पिन वेयर इट इज हैविंग अ 15 कार्बन एटम. जितने ये ऊपर मिथिल ग्रुप्स दिखते हैं उतने ही नंबर ऑफ आइसोप्रीन यूनिट्स होते हैं. ये हमने लास्ट लेक्चर में भी देखा था. इनका स्ट्रक्चर ड्रॉ करना इजी है, जस्ट जितने ऊपर में मिथिल ग्रुप्स आते हैं उतने नंबर ऑफ आइसोप्रीन यूनिट्स होते हैं, और दो मिथिल ग्रुप्स के बीच में एक तीन कार्बन का चेन होता है. 1 2 3 1 2 3, सो थ्री कार्बन का चेन होता है हर दो मिथिल एक्सियल मिथिल की तरफ में, जो वो पॉइंट करते हैं उनके दोनों के बीच में तीन मिथिल ग्रुप. और यहाँ पे ब्रिजिंग पे आपको डबल बॉन्ड बनाना है. सो दिस विल बी गिविंग यू रेस्क्यू टर्पिन. वी कॉल दिस एज ए फार्निसॉल. फार्निसॉल इज द इम्पोर्टेंट और सिंपलेस्ट रेस्क्यू टर्पिन. दिस फार्निसॉल कैन बी जनरेटेड बायोसिंथेसाइज फ्रॉम जेरानिल पायरोफॉस्फेट. जेरानिल पायरोफॉस्फेट वी हैव सिंथेसाइज्ड इट फ्रॉम डीएमएपीपी एंड एलिल एंड आईपीपी. So this is our geranyl pyrophosphate, long elongated structure. We have also drawn it in a cyclic, pseudocyclic type of structure. This we are in a different conformation that way. In this we are doing it in a linear conformation. So in linear conformation, if it loses a pyrophosphate, then we have a cation will be generated. Geranyl cation can be generated. This geranyl cation is stabilized via resonance stabilization of the allylic double bond. So that we have a resonance stabilized structure of this. So this will be geranyl pyrophosphate. This geranyl pyrophosphate, if it is attacked by another IPP unit, isoprene isopentanyl pyrophosphate, then this double bond can attack this terminal carbon cation. It will not be attacking this tertiary carbon cation, tertiary cation, but a terminal primary cation will be attacked, so that a head to tail joining can happen over there. So we will have this as a OPP. Here we will have a cation double bond and a double bond. This we have a stereogenic center. Now loss of stereospecific loss of proton. ये words आने आपके जरूरी है आपके answers में. Stereospecific loss of proton will be giving rise to farnesyl pyrophosphate, or we call it as FPP, farnesyl pyrophosphate or FPP. Here you have to remember this is in E conformation, this is also in E conformation. So we call this as a EE farnesyl pyrophosphate. We can call this as a EE farnesyl pyrophosphate, which can be represented as in a conformation we can have this into a different way we can represent it, like this can be an OPP. Here we have a methyl group. So here this is in a E conformation. This is also in E conformation. So we have this as a EE carnitine pyrophosphate. EE farnesyl pyrophosphate. This can be undergoing isomerization to form a EZ farnesyl pyrophosphate. This is our EE FPP. This can undergo isomerization to form ZE or EZ farnesyl pyrophosphate. EZ farnesyl pyrophosphate. This is important over here, like what we had it in geranyl pyrophosphate में भी जो E conformation था geranyl का वो हमारे लिए cyclization के लिए feasible नहीं था. Cyclization वहां से नहीं हो पा रहा था. लेकिन वैसा ही यहाँ पर हमारा जब EE जब कंफर्मेशन होता है तो वो EE कंफर्मेशन में हमारा साइक्लाइजेशन नहीं हो पाता है, लेकिन ZE में जब कंफर्मेशन आता है देन वी कैन हैव अ साइक्लाइजेशन ऑफ दैट. सो व्हेन देयर इज अ लॉस ऑफ पाइरोफॉस्फेट इज हियर हैपनिंग फ्रॉम हियर, इफ यू लूज द पाइरोफॉस्फेट दैट पाइरोफॉस्फेट कैन बी लॉस्ट टू फॉर्म अ कैटायन here we can have a cation over here. So abhi kya hoga, this cation can then be undergoing cyclization through participation of this double bond. So this double bond can participate and attack on this cationic carbon so that we can have a six member ring over here. Seven member ring yahan nahi banta hai generally, mushkil hota hai thoda, but six member rings can be easily generated from here. So we can have a six membered ring generated, a double bond here, a methyl group, then we have a cation over here. And this we call it as a bisabolyl cation. This we call it as a bisabolyl cation. This bisabolyl cation can then undergo loss of protons depending on which side of it is undergoing loss of proton. It can form three different compounds. It can have a A over here. If this proton is lost, then A. If this proton is lost, B. And this proton is lost, then we have a C. So we can have three different types of bisabolyl cation fates can be generated. So we can have this as a, if A is lost, we have a alpha bisabolol alpha beta bolin. We can generate an alpha beta bolin. Similarly, if B is lost, then we have a beta beta bolin. If C is lost, a proton from C is lost. If a proton from C carbon is lost, then we have a this particular compound, which we call it as gamma bisabolin. We have called this as a gamma bisabolin. So we can have three different bisabolins, alpha, beta, and gamma, depending on which particular proton is lost from here. Similarly, alpha bisabolin can further be hydrolyzed. Alpha bisabolin or the bisabolyl cation can further be hydrolyzed instead of just a loss of protons. These are all loss of protons if it is hydrolyzed. Then we have this as a, if it is hydrolyzed, we will have this here as an OH group. So this we call it as alpha beta bolin. We'll call this as a alpha beta bolin. So this is how fate of beta bolin cation can happen. So diterpenes में यहाँ पे क्या होता है? There are four isoprene units will be combining together. So we have diterpenes with a C20 carbon compound. So this will be having four isoprene units will be combining together to form a diterpenes. So in this case, we can start the biosynthesis of diterpenes from farnesyl pyrophosphate. Farnesyl pyrophosphate is having a 15 carbon compound, so that 15 carbon compound can this is OPP, a double bond and a double bond. So this will be our farnesyl pyrophosphate FPP. This FPP undergoes hydrolysis, loss of pyrophosphate group, so we will have a farnesyl cation. Double bond, and a double. So we will have a farnesyl cation. This farnesyl cation can be stabilized through allylic resonance of this double bond resonance participation to it. Then we can have an attack of IPP, isopentyl pyrophosphate. This attack will result into elongation of chain, further elongation of chain by 5 carbon atoms. So that from this 15 carbon compound, we can have a 20 carbon compound. Reactions are similar to what we have studied it. DMAPP pehla hota hai, uske baad mein har 5 minute ke liye एक एक आईपीपी अंदर में हम ज्वाइन करते जाते हैं. जैसे सिमिलरली हमने फैटी एसिड्स में किया था, एसिटिल कोए एक होता है तो उसके पीछे दो दो कार्बन का मेथोनिल कोए अटैच करते जाते हैं, वैसे ही यहाँ पर भी एक हेमीटर्पिन डीएमएपीपी होता है, उसके आगे में आईपीपी यूनिट्स हम अटैच करते जाते हैं. यहाँ पे दो की जगह पे पांच पांच कार्बन के यूनिट होते हैं, तो इनका जो मल्टीपल्स होता है वो फाइव फाइव कार्बन का मल्टीपल्स में आएगा. What we have to do is this is a 20 carbon compound, so 1, 2, 3, and 4. Fourth wala hume complete karna. So we will have this as an OPP. Yahan par hamara कैटायन जनरेट होगा। ये कार्बन यहाँ पे ज्वाइन हुआ, ये टर्मिनल कार्बन, तो यहाँ पर हमारा कैटायन जनरेट होगा। वी हैव ए एच एस एंड वी हैव ए एच आर, एंड हियर वी हैव ए डबल बॉन्ड एंड ए डबल बॉन्ड। Each of these methyl groups will be pointing to one isoprene unit of 5 carbon each. So 1, 2, 3 and 4, 4, 5, there are 20 carbons are present in this. Now we can have a loss of, stereospecific loss of this proton. It will be stereospecific loss of proton will have a OTP generated, a double bond, double bond, double bond and a double bond. How many double bonds are there? That will also give rise to how many isoprene units are being added to it. This is a 20 carbon compound. So we call this as a geranyl pyrophosphate, or we call this as a GGPP. One G for each geranyl, and each geranyl is having 10 carbon atoms. So two geranyls means 20 carbon atoms. So geranyl pyrophosphate or GGPP can be generated. This is one of the simplest of the diterpenes. Further, simplest of the diterpenes can be obtained by just loss of reduction of these double bonds. So, upon the reduction of these double bonds, we will get now this all carbons will become a stereospecific carbon, or it will become a chiral carbons. This has an OH. So this is a 20 carbon compound. This 20 carbon compound we call it as phytol. This phytol, you will be using this phytol in many different plant growth, in different compounds. One of them is a plant growth hormones. We can use this for synthesis of many different compounds containing 20 carbons or 30 carbon chains. So for that, this phytol is required for there, because it is very difficult to synthesize 30 carbon compound containing a alcohol, because at a terminal alcohol that becomes a little bit difficult to synthesize. This is one of the important ingredient or simplest of the diterpenes. It is also forming a lipophilic chain, lipophilic side chain of the chlorophyll, where this phytol is present in chlorophyll A and other chlorophylls also as a side chain there. Lipophilic side chain, a tail which is utilized for movement of chlorophyll from one part of the cell to another part of the cells there. Now, for recognition purposes, this phytol chain is required there. So this is what is diterpenes.